Do you want to give your tortoise the best possible start in life? A healthy shell is crucial for your pet's overall well-being, and this video reveals what pyramiding is, why it's a concern, and how to prevent it to ensure your tortoise grows strong and healthy. Let's get into it. You want to say hi to the camera? Here, I have my sulcata tortoise Vegeta to help illustrate what shell pyramiding is. As you can see here, these are segments of his shell, which are called scutes. And what shell pyramiding is, are when these scutes grow in an upwards fashion in a pyramid-like shape, rather than smooth and horizontally. As you can see here, he has a very healthy shell and is fairly smooth all around, compared to my other tortoise, Goku. He has a fairly small amount of shell pyramiding as well. And the reason behind that is because when we got him into the pet store, he was very lethargic and did not have the right environmental ingredients for him to thrive. I'll show you Goku here in a little bit. Here I have my other sulcata tortoise, Goku. As I was telling you earlier, you can see that his pyramiding is a little more pronounced than Vegeta's, but is still in great shape. As soon as we got him from the pet store, we were able to mitigate his shell pyramiding. And now he's living a nice, healthy life. It is very common for captive tortoises to have some degree of shell pyramiding because we try to mimic the outside environments or their native environments as much as possible, but it is very hard to get it ideally the same. Now let's talk about why shell pyramiding is a concern. The shell is a part of their skeletal system. Their ribs and their spine are infused on the inner surface of their shell. And pyramiding doesn't only affect the exterior of the shell, but the inside of them too. When a tortoise's shell is deformed, it can cause mobility issues as the shell can affect the spine's alignment, potentially causing discomfort and affecting limb joints, leading to arthritis and difficulty with movement. It can also cause internal organ issues from the shell compressing internal organs like the lungs, affecting breathing and lung capacity. In female tortoises, pyramiding can make it difficult for females to lay eggs, causing egg binding, which is when the tortoise cannot pass eggs due to the shell pyramiding. Now let's talk about why tortoises pyramid and how to prevent it. There are many factors that contribute to tortoises shell pyramiding, but the main reason is dehydration. Sulcata tortoises, especially when young, require areas of high humidity to stay healthy. All tortoises need proper humidity from when they are a baby and throughout their life. But not all tortoises require the same amount of humidity. It's best that you look up the humidity levels that your specific tortoise needs and keep it consistent. It's important that your tortoise has access to fresh water at all times, if they're indoors or in the outdoors. It's important to soak your hatchlings daily and 2 to 3 times a week for your older tortoises to help maintain hydration and shell growth. Another significant factor in pyramiding is lighting and UVB light. It's crucial for tortoises to synthesize vitamin D3, which is essential for calcium absorption and healthy shell growth. In other words, sunlighting and UVB light produce vitamin D3 for tortoises, which allow them to absorb calcium for shell and bone growth. Without vitamin D3, tortoises would have a soft shell and weak bones. I personally keep my tortoises in an outside enclosure with plenty of shade and areas for basking in the natural sunlight. If your tortoise is indoors, it's important to use a UVB light 10 to 12 hours of the day to mimic their natural day-night cycle. If your tortoise is indoors, it's important not to leave on the UVB light overnight. I know a lot of tortoise owners might think that it gets too cold at night for them. I know because I used to be one of them. But they are accustomed to cold nights and handle it very well. Leaving the UVB light on overnight can and will dehydrate your tortoise, causing more harm than good. Your tortoise needs a drop in temperature at night to mimic their natural environment and allow them to thermoregulate. Diet is another factor in tortoises pyramiding. Not getting enough calcium can cause metabolic bone disease or MBD, causing their bones and shell to become soft and weak, potentially leading to fractures and other health issues. Also, overfeeding, even with a seemingly balanced diet, can lead to excessive growth and potentially exacerbate pyramiding. That's why it's important to keep a balanced diet. A lot of tortoises need different diets. Make sure you do some research on how to keep your tortoise thriving with their specific dietary needs. And if you have a sulcata tortoise, watch this video on the top right as I made a video for them specifically. Exercise plays a smaller role, but is just as important for their overall health. Tortoises need plenty of room to roam to be able to move around and exercise. Just like we need to exercise to be strong and healthy, so do they. A tortoise's enclosure should be at least 10 times a tortoise's adult length and 5 times its adult width. The height should be about 3 times a tortoise's adult height. Tortoises are large and active, requiring ample space to roam, explore, and exhibit natural behaviors. A good starting point for a young tortoise is a 9-foot by 8-foot enclosure. Movement and activity help support the absorption of calcium, which promotes bone density and shell growth. Chronic stress from overcrowding can hinder a tortoise's proper growth and development. That's why I let my tortoises out of their enclosure once in a while and allow them to exercise and roam and forage on the grass. It's hard to provide all the essentials a tortoise needs through diet alone. That's why it's recommended to provide supplements so they have the essential vitamins and minerals they need to have a happy and healthy life. It's recommended to give calcium supplements every feeding and multivitamins every 2 to 4 weeks to prevent any nutritional deficiencies. Now for a quick recap. There are many factors that play a role in a tortoise's shell pyramiding. The main factors you want to focus on are 1, humidity and hydration. 2, proper diet and supplements. 3, natural sunlight or UVB light for indoor closures. Focusing on these 3 main factors will help you mitigate your tortoise's pyramiding and allow them to grow happy and healthy. If you have any questions or would like to add some advice or even share your story, please put it down in the comments. We would love to hear from you. Have a great day.